And even though she's 11 years old, she's only been with me for about a year. So I have been training her phenomenal vocabulary for our uses to accept Bertha and help raise money for Condor Conservation. Now, I'll tell you one big difference between condors and these parrots. Parrots have a syrinx right between the lungs. It works like a larynx, a voice box, but they're actually able to stretch that muscle and make sounds, whereas condors do not have that syrinx. So you won't hear a condor make hardly any sounds at all. They have kind of some hisses and some grunts, and that's about it. But we're going to show you some good mimicking ability right now. Hello. Hi. Hello.
Hello, pretty girl.
Can you say hello, pretty girl? Hello, pretty girl.
Hello, pretty girl.
There you go. How are you?
How are you?
I'm doing really good. I'm happy. They're happy.
Wait.
Are you happy? You're going to pull it too fast. Are you happy? Are you happy?
Are you happy, buddy?
There you go. So I think she's having a hard time hearing me. She hears me when I get right down to her face. Now you can tell everybody your full name.
Tika.
Yep. Tika.
Tika Bonica.
Tika Bonica. There you go. Let's play a couple of games. You ready? Tika. Tika. That's right. Here's another one. There you go. Now when I actually touch her, it switches to. Can you throw everybody some kisses? Kisses? Can you hear the word kisses? There you go, good job. Now let's see if we can get her to sing us a couple of songs. Because she sings so many different songs, I'm slowly teaching her to recognize which song to sing by which color I hold up. It's taken a long time, so I'm still giving her some audio cues. But on shows like this, where there's a lot of echo and she can't quite hear the cues, hopefully this will eventually help solve that problem. Here we go. We're going to sing a couple songs, okay? We're going to sing. We're going to start with white and pink frosting, okay? You ready? Ready? Sing up. Sing it. Sing.
Ah.
Sing. This one. Ready? There you go. lose this. All right, now let's bring out our big, let's do a cleanup on aisle five. Don't want the condors walking through anything. Yeah. 37 years of working with birds means 37 years of doing just this right here. That's all right. It's worth it. Now, Tika, you can stop singing back there. All right. Ladies and gentlemen, first bird I want to introduce you to is that gentleman right there. His name is King Edward. I name all of my condors after kings and queens, not because I'm really fond of kings and queens, just because it's the way I feel about them. Now, I will warn you, he comes out, but he doesn't go back in. He hates this cage. The reason is my fault. At first, I had a banner on the back of the cage, really beautiful banner with the logos on it, and he thought it was trying to kill him. So even though I took the banner down, he still thinks that banner is lurking around the corner, and that's why you will never see him go to the back wall. He's been at the front wall the entire time. So he's going to come out looking like a beautifully trained condor, and he may go back in looking like an episode of Cops. So